Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. In my last video, I was talking about a DAG and how you can use it to do some orchestration of notebooks. And I created this graph database in this series of stored procedures that generated the DAG for me. And I was trying to figure out a way to automate this process. And then I had a thought, another boop. I can use user data functions inside of Fabric because these user data functions allow me to create a custom application. So think about the topology I'm using right now. I created a workspace. In the workspace, I created a SQL database. A SQL database has my graph database that contains all the data that I need to generate this JSON document. But I also have a lakehouse in this database, and that lakehouse has a file section. I could drop that DAG into that file section, and I could use a little Python to read it in and run it all in my notebook, and everything's contained within Fabric, a complete solution. So enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let me show you how I created and used this user data function. Let's head to my laptop. So you should read this document. It talks about user data functions, but basically I like this statement right here. It allows you to host and run applications in Fabric. And the benefits are remarkable: reusability, customization, encapsulation, even external connectivity. Now, it is a preview feature, so you need to go out to the admin portal and enable user data functions for your entire organization or specific people. Once you do that, you head back over to your workspace and you choose new item, and we're just going to search for function. We'll choose user data function. You give it a name, so we'll call it the video function. Click create. Once you click create, function is created. If you go over to edit, you can choose manage your connections, where I can add some connections. And that's the first step for me. So you choose add connections. You can choose lakehouses, warehouses, or SQL databases in Fabric. The document goes and talks about all the possible sources and what you can do with them. Some you can read, some you can write. It just depends on the source. Once you have those created, then you click new function here. I think it gives you like a hello world function that you can use. If you want to run it, you just click run. And then if I click Patrick and choose run, you'll see it'll give some output right here. Welcome to Fabric Functions, Patrick, at this time. What I also like is that if you go over to edit, you can insert samples. There's lots of different samples. Export data from warehouse to lakehouse, query data in the warehouse, write multiple rows. There's so many different things, data manipulation, different types of functions. You can even add your own custom libraries. And so right now it's just this one, but if I wanted to add other different types of libraries, I can add them here so I can use them within my code. I go back to home, I can generate invocation code. So what this means is I can take this out to a client application. You can see right here, I can copy this. I can switch this over to a notebook and it writes, you know, some Python up for me using notebook utils. Everything that I need is just contained right here, and it's producing things I need if I want to execute my function outside of just the execution that happens here within this interface. I like the way it's self-contained. What you also see if you go over to either home or edit, there's a publish option. So once you've written all the code and you want to use this, you would click publish and then that function will be available. I'm going to close this one, and like a cooking show, I'm going to show you a function that I created here. So you remember in the other video, I created a stored procedure that generates a DAG for me. And so you can see I have a function here called export DAG, and you can have multiple functions when you create the function. And so you can see right here, I imported, it does this automatically. And then I have my user data functions, but then it specifies some connectivity for me. And so if I go over to manage connections, you see these aliases here, and you need these aliases. And if you want to, you can change them. You can update these to different names. It auto generates these for you. So I just accepted them. And when this is first created, it says enter alias here, and that's all I did. And then you define your function. When you define your function, in your function definition, you can have input parameters. Right now, I don't have any besides the connections, which are passed right here. Then I connected to my SQL server, and then I ran that stored procedure. And then I just fetched the result into a list, and then I extracted that out into another variable. And I had to replace some things that was at the beginning and end. I don't know, maybe I could do this a little more elegantly. And then I opened up the connection to my lakehouse, and then I initialized a variable that contains not only the name of the file, but the path to the file. And so if you don't prefix the name of the file with the path, it's just going to write it to the file section, the root of files. And that's not what I want. And then I actually get the file, and then I upload it to the lakehouse, clean up, close everything, and return an output. And so if I go here to the lakehouse, you'll see right now, let's do a quick refresh. There's nothing in the DAG folder under meta. If I go back over to my function, once it's published, and these are published already, once it's published, if you click play, you'll get a little interface over here. If there were any parameters, you would have to input your parameters, and then you click run. Give it a second. If there's no errors, you'll get an output, and it's going to tell you what exactly happened based on whatever you're returning in your output. And so you can see it says, hey, the DAG containing all this stuff was written to my lake house. If I go over to my lake house, do a quick refresh, there's the DAG. If I click it, you can see all, there's my document right there. So now all I got to do whenever I go use those stored procedures to add nodes and edges, I just come here and run this. It'll drop this into that folder for me. Now I can go over into my notebook and do some automation of this. So if I go over into my notebook, I'm using another library here to get the contents of that text file into a variable. So if I run this, I got the contents into a variable and then I'll print it out. You can see here's the contents right here. This is everything I need. If I copy this and go over to VS Code, let's do it. We're gonna copy this. We're gonna paste this in. We're gonna format this just so you can see. Same thing, right? Same thing. And now if I run this, it should start up and then you'll see the dependencies. You'll see my four notebooks that's going to run just like before. And then you'll see two of them start. These are the first two that don't have any dependencies. Once they complete, you'll see the other ones start up and execute. And now I don't have to type this thing up. I don't have to copy and paste it from my stored procedure execution into the notebook. Anytime someone makes a change, they just need to go fire off this function. We can actually make this function part of our ETL process, and then it'll automatically pick up that graph and orchestrate all my notebooks to run that way. What? But then I had another idea. Boom. Could I use Translytical to do this? Well, you gotta wait for the next video to find out about that. All right, did you watch the other video? If not, go check it out. What do you think? Are you using user data functions? I'd love to know. If you have any questions or comments, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, all the workloads in Fabric, I'm sure there's a video flying above my head. And as always, from Martha, Adam, this guy, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. So exciting.